Biodiversity is all life on Earth. My country, the Philippines, is among the 17 megadiverse countries in the world. The country hosts more than 52,000 known species, with more than 50% of our plants and animals classified as unique. On a per unit basis, the Philippines probably harbors more diversity of life than any other country in the planet. Unfortunately, Philippine biodiversity is threatened and vulnerable. We are still among the 35 biodiversity hotspots, ranked as the 10th most threatened biodiversity hotspot in the world. As a member of Philippine Congress, and previously as governor of the province of Occidental Mindoro, I have always been a strong advocate of sustainable management of our biodiversity. But more importantly, I wanted to work on financing solutions so that all these policies and programs could actually be implemented so they could actually work. There was a need to better understand the economic value of our country's precious biodiversity and the finance so crucially needed to help in its conservation. That is where my partnership with the Biodiversity Finance Initiative, or BIOFIN, proved to be serendipitous. In 2017, BIOFIN provided the rigorous assessment to determine the economic value of the ecosystem services in the Philippines, which is valued at approximately 2.3 trillion pesos, or about 45 billion US dollars. Despite these benefits that we get from our natural wealth, our biodiversity is sadly in severe decline due to anthropogenic and natural threats. Unfairly, it also receives the least priority in terms of government budgeting. In fact, the average annual biodiversity spending was only at 4.9 billion pesos or $110 million from 2008 to 2013, which is equivalent to a mere 0.08% of the gross domestic product and 0.31% of the national budget. With the state of biodiversity decline at crisis levels, BIOFIN and I agreed something needs to be done. We have to act now. We have to help ensure that the funding gap to fund biodiversity relevant actions is narrowed. This is why we adopted the Bayanihan concept, or the whole of government approach, to financing biodiversity conservation. This is how we were able to enact the Expanded National Integrated Protected Area System Act, or the INAIPAS Act of 2018. As a principal author of this law, BIOFIN and I worked with fellow legislators, national executive agencies, and non-government organizations to ensure its passage. With the INAIPAS law, there are 94 new national parks legislated as protected areas. From only 13, there are now 107 protected areas across 15 regions and 53 provinces, covering approximately 10% of our country's total land area. Apart from improving and updating conservation, protection, and management of these protected areas and its rich biodiversity, this law now mandates regular budget allocation every year through the annual national government budget. This effectively eliminates the unpredictable and unsustainable financing and budgets for biodiversity conservation. Because we are in a catch-up mode to narrow the biodiversity financing gap. A more comprehensive and systematic financing solution must be undertaken. Taking off from the recent enactment of the INAIPAS law, a nationwide investment program for protected areas is currently being developed. While still being finalized, this investment program aims to allocate over 20 billion pesos in a span of 3 years, which will ensure that infrastructure, capacity building, and institutional transformation needs are met. This investment program is aimed to be included in the national government budget starting next year. When Congress begins deliberating on this, we will again use the Bayanihan approach to mobilize broad support and ensure its approval. The Philippines is also losing trillions of pesos to foreign countries in the form of royalties that they earn from patenting specific uses of our genetic resources, but not a single centavo returns to the Philippines. In response, BIOFIN and I developed a proposed legislation to strengthen the country's policy on access and benefit sharing from the use of Philippine genetic resources. This aims to eliminate the wanton disregard for equitable benefit sharing while highlighting the value and importance of customary laws as well as the community protocols of indigenous and local communities. It will enable the country to generate funds from royalties to be used for biodiversity conservation and other sustainable development initiatives. Through Bayanihan, we are employing two tracks for this. One, we are working with the Executive Department for an executive order to be signed by the President, organizing all relevant agencies to a council that will regulate access and benefit sharing. And two, we have filed a proposed legislation in Congress that will institutionalize this council, provide sufficient budgets, and strengthen the national policy on access and benefit sharing. While the Bayanihan approach to financing biodiversity conservation mobilizes the collective resources of different stakeholders, our main principle continued to be this: the national government must be the primary driver, mover, and shaker for biodiversity financing through meaningful legislations, effective implementation, and appropriate financing and budgeting. By sending this clear message, all other stakeholders will hopefully and eventually follow. Because at the end of the day, financing solutions for biodiversity conservation are actually our collective investment for the future of our children and our children's children. Thank you.